Pastor Justin here, coming live from my couch. Once again, but things are starting to change. We're getting closer and closer to seeing your beautiful faces. We miss you guys a lot. It really bothers me because I'm a people person, and I do not like being quarantined inside a house whatsoever. I like to be around people at all times. So I miss you guys a lot. I can't wait to see you guys. It's coming soon. Today we have a great day. I have a special guest speaker. You're going to be shocked who it is. It's going to be awesome. This person has a great word for us, and so I can't wait for you guys to hear it. I'm going to open up in prayer before we transition. Let's pray real quick. Father God, we thank you for this day. We thank you for allowing us to come into your presence, and that we can just connect with you, Father. That we can just sit at your feet and just worship you, Father God, and all that we do, Father. So this morning, as we press into worship, Father, I pray, God, your spirit just fills the room, whether it be the bedroom, whether it be the living room, kitchen, in the shower, whatever, Father. I pray, God, that your spirit will flow and flow through us into us this morning. And let us just worship your glorious name. And everybody said, amen. All right, guys, let's switch it over with Pastor Jason. It's a little bit of worship.
Mention of your name. cross, you're the great I am. I will exalt you. I will exalt you, Jesus. You are the great I am. I will exalt you, Jesus. You're the great I am. I will lift your name up higher, higher. Power in your name, oh, this power in your name, Lord, Jesus, Jesus, there is power in the name of Jesus, oh, there is power in the name of my God, oh, there is power in the name of Jesus. Holy name, Lord Jesus, Jesus, oh, this power in your name, Jesus, Jesus. You're the great I am, yes you are, Lord. You're the great I am, you are greatly to be praised, great I am. We will exalt you today, God, you're the great I am. How we love you today, God, you're the great I am. Exalt you today, God. I will exalt you today, God, 'cause you're the great I am. What can stand against you? There is nothing, there is no one, no disease can stand against you. You're the great I am. You're the great I am.
Hey guys, welcome back. Thank you, Pastor Jason, for leading us in worship this morning. Man, I love listening to him sing. It's just so genuine, so pure, and it comes, you know, directly from his heart to the Father's heart. And so, anyway, so this morning, I want to transition. I want to welcome a very special guest, very close to my heart. It's my beautiful wife, Pastor Esther. I asked her to bring the word this morning. I can't wait to hear what she has to have for you guys and for all of us, truthfully. And so, I'll turn it over to my wife, Pastor Esther.
Thank you, Pastor Justin. I'm very excited to speak to everyone today. So when Pastor Justin asked me to speak, honestly, I was just asking Holy Spirit to really, really just show me what direction to go. I just wanted to be in His will and just meet y'all where y'all are at right now. So, Father, I just come to you and I ask, Father, that you would speak through me, Lord God, that I would just be a mouthpiece, Father, and that everyone who's watching right now, Lord God, that their ears are ready to hear, Father God, you talking directly to them, Lord God. You only use me as a vessel, but every word that I say, Father God, comes from you, Lord. In Jesus' name, amen. So, For me, I really felt just the importance talking about how valuable you are, how important you are to God, to the Father, that He created you, that He made you in His image, that He calls you by name, that He has a purpose and a plan for you, that you are loved, and that you are accepted. And so many times we may question ourselves, like, are we important? You know, does anyone even know I exist? Are people thinking about me right now? And I went through that. I went through a lot of challenges in life where I felt unaccepted, not important, not valuable, or feeling like I didn't have gifts, or trying to walk in someone else's footsteps, trying to do things that maybe my sister or someone else was good at, and trying to find my gifts that way. So I'm going to read a scripture to you, and it's Psalms 139. Lord, you have searched me and known me. You know my sitting down and my rising up. You understand my thought afar off. You comprehend my path and my lying down, and are acquainted with all my ways. He is acquainted with you, with all your ways, with every thought, with everything that you go through. He knows you. He knows what you're going to do. He knows your thoughts, and He's always with you. There were so many times in my life where I felt alone, but when I realized who I was in Him, I was about 15 years old. And I remember going through life before 15, just feeling bullied by people, not feeling accepted. And I was entering in high school and I thought, it's going to be different. And it wasn't. I was made fun of. I was pushed to the ground. And I remember that morning when I had a group of girls trying to look at my ear, which some of y'all may not know, but I was born with only one ear, so I'm created different. So my big thing in life was, why am I created the way I am? Like, I did not understand why I was born with 10 fingers or with 2 ears. I didn't understand why I had to face the things that I did. And that day, when I went home in tears, I saw a vision of Jesus dying on the cross, and it was like I was there, like I was in the crowd, and I saw Him being spit on, and I saw Him being whipped, and I saw the blood dripping, and I realized at that moment that no wound, that no hurt, no pain, no nothing that I could go through would be as painful as what He went through for me, for the love, for what He had for me. And you know, after that moment, I realized who I was in Christ, of what the value I was, and the pain that He went through for me. And that moment, I was able to put my hair in a ponytail. That moment, I didn't hide who I was anymore. That moment, I stepped in confidence in who I was in Christ. And so I want y'all to look at a quick video, because I want you to know how important you are, and it starts by your name.
Hi, my name is Audrey, and the meaning of my name is noble strength. And the verse that I found to go along with it is Proverbs 31:30-31. And that is, charm is deceptive and beauty is fleeting, but a woman who fears the Lord is to be praised. Honor her for all that she has done, and let her works bring praise at the city gates.
Hi, I'm Hannah, and my name means grace. Ephesians 2:8, for by grace we are saved through faith, and that not of ourselves, it is the gift of God.
Hi, my name is Emmanuel. My name means God with us, so everywhere I go, God is with us.
Hi, my name is Camille, and my name means serving at the altar, so that means I serve God with all of my heart, I guess.
I'm Skylar, and the meaning of my name is protection, And the Bible verse that goes with our name is 2 Corinthians 9:7. You must each decide in your heart how much to give, and don't give reluctantly or in response to pressure, for God loves a person who gives cheerfully.
My name is Jalen Orm. It means funny and intelligent person. A good scripture to go with that is Job 8:21. It says, God will yet fill your mouth with laughter and your lips with shouts of joy. How I got my name was my parents put their names together.
My name is Zelly. Zelly comes its origin from Greek. And that's what my parents named me. My mom said she didn't really have a reason to name you Zelly. She just did. My name means eternal life and is used 134 times in the New Testament. Eternal life, Zoe, is the whole future of the redeemed and final glory and reward to which the children of God enter. Jesus says he is the way, the truth, and the life, or Zoe. That's what my name means.
My name is Zechariah. And my name means Yahweh remembers. My parents named me Zechariah because Zechariah the prophet spoke about restoration to the Israelites. My parents felt like I was not only going to bring restoration to our family, but also bring restoration to our generation.
Hey guys, I hope y'all enjoyed that video. I just wanted to use some of your friends and let you see what their names meant. I think it's so important for us to know what our names meant, where we came from, why our parents named us our name. I remember growing up not really liking my name. I felt like my name was an old name. I always thought of Sanford and Son, Aunt Esther, which some of y'all probably don't know who that is. But anyway, that's what I thought, or you know how sometimes some of us have names that rhyme and we don't like the names that it rhymes with. So for me, I just looked at my name as an old name and not a name that was valuable. Anyway, so as I got older and I really realized the meaning of my name and the importance of my name and realized that my name had importance and a value is when I started loving who I was, what my name was, and it meant something to me. So today I wanted to finish in closing by reading Isaiah 43:1. But now thus says the Lord, who created you, O Jacob, and he formed you, O Israel, fear not, for I have redeemed you, and I have called you by your name, you are mine. So he has called you by name, and you are his. So I just want y'all to know how important your name is and the value to it. And I can't wait to meet with you during our Zoom at 4 o'clock, where we can discuss more about the value of your name. And even if you don't know what the meaning of your name is, go look it up and we'll discuss it together at 4 o'clock. Let me leave you with a prayer. Father, I just thank you for our students. I thank you that they're valuable. I thank you that they're fearfully and wonderfully made, Lord. And I pray today, Lord God, that they would just want to go and look up their name and who they are, and that today is a new day and they realize that they are born with a purpose and a plan. In Jesus' name, amen.